Movie Think Show, where we watch movies in the theaters and then we tell you what we think about them. Mm-hmm. I'm Meg Turney.
My name's Joe Beretta, and we watched Ender's Game.
If you want to watch Ender's Game this weekend, of course, check it out in theaters, but you can also go to netflix.com/sourcefed to get a free month of instant streaming. If you can't go to the theater, then you can join us on Movie Club.
You can't watch Ender's Game there, but you can watch other cool space sci-fi fare like Starship Troopers.
Like Joe said, we watched Ender's Game this week. Joe, one-line summary, what's this movie about?
Future society utilizes children to train for space warfare against alien race that threatens their existence.
Boom! Also, Butterfield plays Ender in this game. Kind of a relative unknown. I'd never heard of him before.
He is the kid that was in Hugo, actually. The cutie that worked with Scorsese.
Harrison Ford is also in this film.
He plays Colonel Graf. We've got, it's like a star-studded young kid cast. There's also Abigail Breslin, who plays Ender's sister, Valentine. There's also Haley Steinfeld.
Steinfeld
is her name, and she was the girl from True Grit remake.
And also Ben Kingsley is in this film, but let's talk about the performances, because this book, movie adaptation, the performances have to be strong, because there's so much you can't, like in a book you can explore their feelings, but in a movie you really just have to convey.
Well, and it's also a book that is beloved by a lot of people, including ourselves. We both read the book. As far as the performances go, I think Asa Butterfield was great as Ender. He did, he was empathetic, but also was able to pull off stoic perfectly. I really enjoyed his performance.
I thought he did very, very well.
Harrison Ford, I think, did a great job of not doing what I feel like he's been doing in the last, like, 10 films he's been in, which is slowly dying on film.
I know! In this one, he didn't have mush mouth. I could understand him in this movie, and I was so excited!
Apparently, Harrison Ford only cares these days if he's doing space fare.
Which I get behind.
But he did fine. I mean, Harrison Ford's range in his older age is probably about like this, but what he did in this area, I felt suited the film and suited the character just fine.
Absolutely. The only gripe I have about acting this film was Abigail Breslin. I thought she sucked. I thought she was cheesy. I did not care for her as Valentine at all. I just felt like I was hearing her read.
Here's why I think you probably had a problem with her and you're calling it cheesy. And I think this is a problem throughout the film. It's the same problem that I had with The Hobbit. These books that people love, the directors have the chore of getting all the major moments into it to, one, get the story across, and two, to make the fanboys happy. And I think they did that with Ender's Game. In Ender's Game, they get all the major, like, big plot points that you remember from reading the book. They put them in the movie, and it's really faithful, right?
Mm-hmm, absolutely. I was very surprised by how faithful it was.
But in saying that, you've only got an hour and a half to 2 hours, and the movie's a two-hour movie, and they fit everything in, and the thing that becomes kind of expendable, which I think is sad, and they did the exact same thing with The Hobbit, is that there's not a lot of character development. There's not a lot of time to figure out who Ender is, to become empathetic with his journey, with his life, and I think that happened to Valentine and Peter, the other really important sibling in the book. They're just kind of glossed over.
Yeah.
Like, you know that their existence is important, but we didn't have enough time to fall in love with it.
I agree.
So we go into, hey, this is Ender. Oh, okay, well, you're telling us he's an underdog, but we don't feel that he's an underdog.
Right.
And it's the same with the relationship with his sister. It's like, you know that they're somehow bound together emotionally because of this two-second scene we see with Peter, the evil older brother. But because of that, we take this whole movie journey, and it's hard to feel the emotional stakes.
Absolutely, and I had heard from people who had seen this ahead of time who hadn't read the book that they really liked the movie, and it surprised me because having read the book, I understood so much more what they were going for, but if I hadn't read the book, I felt like this movie would have been very disjointed for me.
I'd like to know how somebody feels that is a 15-year-old kid, which is the demographic that the movie is about, what they feel that if they haven't read the book, I want to know their review of the movie, but then I'd also want to know two 30-year-old people sitting on the couch talking to the internet who have not read the book. I'd like to know what their review is as well, because I do think it's a solid movie, but I also think that I was able to connect with the characters a lot more than other people will that haven't read the book.
This is the part where normally we talk about story, which we just did, total spoiler free, but we're gonna talk about some spoilers here, because this is based on a book, and if you haven't read the book or seen the movie, you can click down here somewhere, and it'll skip over to the next part of the review. So, how it related to the book, you were right, they fit in so much of the quintessential moments of the book. I was surprised that they did that. However, I felt like there were some parts that were watered down. The shower scene, I feel like I remember it being so much more violent in the book.
Yep.
In the movie, it's just kind of like, he shoves him and he hits his head and oh no, he might die, he might not die, but in the book he definitely dies. I just felt like it was watered down a little bit.
A lot of the emotional relationships were watered down. One of the things that we're talking about earlier is the sibling rivalry within the Ender family unit. Ender is the middle ground between a sister who is this super loving, super empathetic person, and that's the reason she washed out of the fleet, and then the borderline psychopathic brother who was prone to violence. Ender is right in the middle, and we don't quite get to understand who Ender is because we don't understand who these two people
are. No, and he literally says a line in the film, like, they told me not to be like Valentine or Peter, I have to find a balance, but you don't get to feel that, and it is disappointing.
Yeah, and that also, that glossing over of character development also hits the other important characters of the book, which just become names in the movie. Bean is in the movie. You don't really care about Bean. Eli is in the movie. You don't really care about Eli. Even Petra. Petra becomes the confidant in the movie, but you still don't really care too much
about it. Yeah, it almost seemed borderline romantic in the movie, which in the book you never really get. Like, it doesn't really seem like he likes... She becomes a replacement for Valentine in the book, but in the movie it almost seems like she has, like, this crush on him, which is very weird. Also, they leave the game in, which I was very happy that
The mind game.
That's in the movie, but it's only in the movie very, very briefly, and that was sad because I feel like it's such a big part of Ender going to discover this empathy for this alien race.
Yeah, it's, in the book, the mind game is probably like, it's extended out this far, and you go through the whole book and you keep going back to it, like, intermittently. But in the movie, the whole idea of the mind game is still there, they just address it this much. So the journey for the mind game is like 5 minutes, but they got all the important parts of it because the ending of the mind game is still in the movie.
So I think overall they did a great job of adapting the book. Since I love the book so much, I'm like, oh, someone doesn't get that emotional impact. Also, the twist ending is not really a twist in this movie. I mean, it's barely a twist, if that, because we're not stuck in the book, we're stuck at Ender's point of view, and we don't know that this fleet is coming in on enemy airspace, but in the movie, you actually see the fleet moving in, and you see Graf looking at a countdown of when he's gotta get Ender to command this ship. So it's like the best part of that book is, oh my God, it was real, and you don't really get that in the movie.
Yeah. It's a little rough. Plus, again, the battle simulation is a character in itself that you're supposed to immerse yourself in. You're supposed to watch these kids make this journey from becoming kids to these battle commanders, and they gloss over the fact that it's a simulation. It goes over real quick. But that's not a fault of, I think, the director so much as it is. It's just a very complex book, and it's a complex story. And I feel like Gavin Hood, the director, did a really good job of conveying, from a fanboy and a story point, most of the book.
I agree. So let's move on to visual effects. I thought this was a beautiful movie.
Yeah, it looks super crisp, like nothing wrong with the visuals. I was reading a review where they were complaining about the mind game visuals, but I don't think they understood that, like, they needed to make that look like a video game compared to the rest of the amazing graphics in the movie.
Right. Also, I thought that there was going to be a lot more stomach-churning scenes because so much of the battle room is them figuring out and reorienting themselves, and it's very, like, nauseating. There is one scene when he first comes on and something's rotating, and it started to make me nauseous, but actually, none of this movie made me nauseous.
No, it was... Oh, you mean nauseous from a space standpoint.
Yeah,
I got what you're saying.
Well, like in Gravity, I was like, whoa,
I thought you meant from, like,
times.
Ender just messes people up and gives their bloods and guts a front row seat to your face.
No.
No, they kept the violence back, but the idea of violence there, the idea of turning kids into soldiers, I thought was there.
That was really good.
I thought the Formic race, or the buggers as they're called in the book, how they made them was great.
Yeah, I thought they looked really,
really,
really
cool. Really cool looking. They incorporated the fact that they were resembling the ants on Earth, and yeah, it was great. It was like the ants on Earth plus the Starship Trooper buggers pushed together, and then there they were.
Welcome to Ender's Game.
The production, the overall look of the movie was done really well. The whole futuristic society was great.
So we're not the only ones who saw this movie. Right now, has a 75% from audiences, which is pretty good, and a 63% from critics.
But when it comes to critics, isn't that bad? Over on Internet Movie Database, it's got a 7 out of 10, so I think overall it's making people pretty happy. And for myself, I would say it's not a great movie, but it was really good. I enjoyed it. As somebody that loves the book and has read it 100 times, I enjoyed the movie a lot.
What would you give it?
Would I give it on a scale? Probably hovering right around 7.5, 8.
Yes, if you love the book, go see this movie. Honestly, I know a lot of times people who really love books are afraid of going to see the movie because they don't want anything ruined. It's a very faithful adaptation, and they did a great job with it. I'm going to give it an 8 out of 10.
And then would you suggest that people that haven't read the book go see it as well?
I would say people who haven't read the book, please, if you have just a free weekend, it's a super quick read. I promise I read it in a day. Read the book first, because I think it does so much more and adds so much more to the movie. You get so much more to the movie if you know what they're talking
about. But like 5 or 6 of you don't read the book, go watch it and let me know how you feel, because I'd like to know your mindset. Because while I'm sitting there watching this movie, I'm like, I wish, I'm stuck in my head because I want to know what it'd be like if I didn't read the book first, so. It's an enjoyable flick. It feels like a good summer flick that came out in November.
Absolutely. You guys, don't forget, if you can't make it to the movies this weekend, you can always go to netflix.com/sourcefed to get a free month of instant streaming, and then you can join us on Movie Club.
What?
I'm Meg Turney.
I'm Joe Beretta.
Don't forget to like, subscribe, this annotation for human people, sourcefed.com. Good stuff.
Bye-bye.